D&D gang, what's going on, guys? Another video today. You know the drill. If you don't, take half a second. Click subscribe to the channel. Today is a different day, guys. It is a different day. First of all, the water data on this river is wrong. They said this was 480 CFS this morning. It's running like 750. Maybe 800. That's okay. Today, it's cool out. I'm in long sleeves, obviously. Maybe it's 67 degrees. Last night was pretty cold. It's quiet. It just feels very, very calm today. So it's going to be a different style video. I know sometimes I get a little crazy on you guys and we do some crazy stuff and you know, it is what it is, but today's gonna be a little different. I'm gonna try to make this video relaxing, okay? Now, we might get into a huge trout today because the water's up a little. It's kind of cool out. It's very, very cloudy, completely overcast. So we may get into a big trout. If that happens, the mood might change a little bit. But today, it's gonna be a nice, calm summer fly fishing video. If you like that kind of thing, click the subscribe button for me. It helps me out. And, yeah, there's not a whole lot to say. We're up here. We're going for a wild brown trout. I do have the good camera with me. So here in about a second, I'm going to grab that. I'm going to show you guys the exact flies that we're going to be starting with, just so you know exactly what I'm using. And let's get right to fishing today.
Now, this is a weird setup. Very weird setup. I was assuming this would only be for dry flies tonight. So I had a long leader. It was really light. I think it's like in between 5 and 6X tippet. Definitely just heard one rise behind me. That's a really good sign. I did switch this over from our dry fly setup. As you can see, pretty big woolly bugger. And then a little simple gray jigged streamer. Now this is on very, very light tippet. I do not recommend you guys fish woolly buggers or even little jig streamers on 5, especially 6X. This is a little bit stronger. You almost want to have 4X minimum if you're going to fish this type of setup. But I just don't have the option to do that tonight. So I'm going to have to just be very, very delicate and not set the hook and kind of keep my rod to the side so there's more give to the line. But the water levels are just screaming. Put on something pretty decent size. I think there might be some larger trout out cruising tonight, especially as the evening goes on. So I definitely want to give these a try. We'll be able to swing them across the current, cover a lot of water, hopefully come across a nice 20-inch brown trout.
Alrighty guys, seen a couple of fish rise. Almost feel like I should have left the dry fly on, but I think they'll take this bugger. They're in pretty close. So we're just gonna roll cast these out, swing them through the shallow, see if we can get one early here. Just gotta kind of work our way out. We don't want to spook any fish. Oh, that might even been a fish right there. Hard to say. So we're just swinging those two woolly buggers down through this little shallow bank. I know there's a couple of small fish in there. Might be able to pick off a small one first. We'll just slowly work our way out here. I just don't want to spook anything. The water's up, but it's stained and these fish are gonna be feeding pretty heavy tonight. Now you can see that drop off, the difference in the color of the bottom. The trout are gonna be right on that edge, right on it. So we're just swinging those buggers out there on tension, waiting for them to just get whacked on the swing. And that's where this tippet's gonna come into play, because like I told you guys, I went really light with the tippet. So I'm a little nervous, especially if we hook a big trout. It's all about the hook set. Once we hook them, I can fight them on light drag. Oh, just had one. Just had a trout, guys, already on the two buggers. I'm gonna leave him out there. Maybe he's following. Felt like a pretty good fish too. It was right on that drop, right on that current seam. Can you guys see where the color is changing on the bottom? This could be a really productive night. Oh, I just had it again. He's nipping the tail of it. Let's see if we can get him again. Maybe it's a small fish. Maybe it's a big one that's just kind of fighting off his spot. give it a couple strips here. Throw it out just a hair farther, just ever so slightly farther. We're up here alone tonight, which is rare this time of year. There's usually people here. Conditions are really good. Let's see if we can pick one up. Man, those were two pretty good hits. I wish you guys could feel exactly what I feel instead of just watching on camera, but just kind of covering our tracks, feel a little more comfortable to move out just a little bit farther. Now we'll throw a little bit over into this deeper current here. Let those buggers float down. Now one's a little small gray jig streamer, and that one could be the ticket. Oh, there we go. Got him. Okay. So he was right on that current seam. He hit a couple of times. Nice brown trout. This could end up being a very productive night. We could figure out the exact pattern. He was sitting right on the edge of the change in color of the bottom. Nice little brown trout. We'll see which one he took. Did he take the big one or the little one? I think he took the small one, guys. What do we got? He took the little gray jig streamer. What do we got, a wild? Yep, that's a wild brown trout. Cool, let's send him back. Have a nice day. Let's go find a big one. Maybe we'll tighten up our cast a little here. See if we can get one in close to the bank. Just like that, throw him end. Hopefully there's a big one in there. Hopefully there's a big one in there somewhere. Yep, there we go. Got another trout. Oh my gosh, came off. Felt like a pretty good trout. It's hard to say. I think we're going to come across a pretty good fish. Maybe we'll set a goal right now. I think we can, I think we can get a nice 15, 16 inch trout tonight with these conditions. Did not expect to be doing this tonight, but hey, you got to improvise.
For drive. Flies.
Oh my gosh, big trout just came up right for my flies as soon as it hit the surface, guys. Nice trout in the teens right under this branch. Let's see if we can pick this trout up. This is a tough cast. I'm gonna have to really line drive it in there, just like that. We're gonna throw it a mend, and then we're gonna give it a little tension. He should be right in there somewhere. Soon as my flies hit the water, he came up for it. Now, could I take a huge gamble and switch to a dry and see if we could get that fish? Maybe, but we're not gonna do that. I gotta get in a little closer to the bank. These branches make it real difficult. See if we can slingshot one in there. That's pretty good. Let's see if we can get him. I might still be a little bit short. Oh, I just felt a tap. Could be on it, he could be on it. Just gonna continue the swing. This is kind of fun here, guys, swinging these flies. That looked like a really good trout, too.
Just rigged up the Euro rod. I had to completely redo it. So this is a 10.5-foot three-weight, if anyone's new to the channel. It's a Cortland competition. Simple reel, cheap reel. You don't really use the reel. Everything's with your hands. So if you guys are trying to figure out what Euro setup to buy, put your money in the rod and the line. So that's our point fly. That's a DSHS. That's on my website. So if you guys want to use this exact fly, you're welcome to support the channel. Buy a couple of these. They've been killing it lately. And then as a dropper, we have this little kind of a caddis emerger. Kind of a wet fly, just something different. Some green, some color on there, something to change it up.
Alrighty, this looks pretty good here. Gotta try to line drive those under. Perfect. Slide down just a hair. There you go. Let's see if we can get this trout. It's a good drift. He's right in there somewhere. Nope. We'll try it again. I feel like I gotta get down just a little more. Get these things up current. There we go. There we go. Good drift. Let him get down to the level. Bring him right through. Perfect dead drift. Where's that trout? Where's that trout? He probably looked at it.
Alrighty guys, starting to get dark out. Super early tonight, but this is what we're going with. I believe it's a 14.
Oh, dang. All the way in the back. Went for it. Don't know how I missed that. And he's sitting way back in that calm spot. Alrighty guys, the rain's coming down. It's awesome. I freaking love this weather. I still have high hopes. I'm not gonna give up. I think we can get a really big one here, right at the buzzer. Still got about an hour of this weird intermediate twilight dim lighting, but yeah, I'm back to the tandem rig, back to the double streamers with this rain and this dim lighting. Got to get some meat out there, so I wish I had my 7-weight with the sinking line. I would chuck some big streamers right now, but the rain's picking up, and I'm already wet. I fell in, so we're just going to fish right into the darkness, go back to swinging these streamers. That was what was most effective, so let's get back in there, get another trout. Boom, I'm just waiting on it. I'm not losing focus. Right when you lose focus, you get your chance. There might be some content that I'm only gonna be able to get on my phone, so make sure you guys swing by my Instagram and throw me a follow. Almost to 8,000 followers on there. I appreciate it, guys. Definitely join the gang. Oh my gosh, I just got drilled, guys. I just got drilled. That was the bite we needed. I just took a step and this bugger was hanging back behind me and I finally got murdered. That was not light. I can't believe it didn't break off. That was a full, I gotta get right back in. He's probably looking for it. The fish we're after for sure. That was a legit take. Way different than everything today. There he goes. I got something. I got a fish. I'm running out of line. I'm running out of freaking line, guys. I have no idea how big this trout is. My rod was so far behind me, I couldn't bring in the slack. No idea how big this trout is, but we're hooked up in the dark. Maybe it's that fish. Maybe it's him. I have no idea. Is it big? Oh, yeah. It looks pretty big. Yep, that's him. Guys, we got him. We hooked that big trout. Yeah, look at it. Oh my gosh, guys, it's a real big one. Right at the buzzer. I knew this was gonna happen today. Right at the buzzer, we're hooked up with a big one. Oh my gosh, look at this thing. Real big one. Come here, buddy. Yeah! Oh, we got it done! At the buzzer! Right at the buzzer, big one.
Look at this brown trout, guys. Awesome, right at the end. Alrighty, let's let him go. Well, let's get a quick measurement. So nose, tail to nose. He's just short of the opening of my net by about 2 inches, so I'll put that measurement on the screen. I'll do that when I'm home. Let's let this guy go. Beautiful brown trout. Awesome. There he goes. Right there. Right at the end, guys. It's just about dark. It's about 9 o'clock. Soaking wet. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.